One of the things we study that you can't see is wind. It flows through the mountains, it flows over the mountains, around the mountains, and it's a very difficult thing to forecast. We developed wind shear technologies, and those were deployed at airports around the United States. We've also developed technologies to help pilots avoid icing, turbulence, thunderstorms, and other aviation hazards. We know from our work in hurricane research and tornado research that high winds can be very deadly. However, high winds have a big benefit, and that's with wind energy.
Wind energy is important to the United States because it is a domestic supply. It's a renewable source of energy. It doesn't produce chemical and CO2 pollution. Very important to us in the West is that it doesn't take any water in the production of electricity. So for many reasons, wind is a homegrown resource that we can take advantage of. Here at the Wind Energy Research Center, we study everything from the low-level wind that makes the turbine spin, to blade materials, to blade construction, to all the components of the wind turbine that cause electricity to be produced and then put on the grid. In the wind tunnel, we're studying aerodynamic blade shapes to better understand how they perform in the atmosphere. We seed the air with olive oil particles, and when we snap a picture of the flow that's illuminated by a laser, we capture all these particles.
This is the blade section here, and then we can see the olive oil particles moving in the flow field.
And from that, we can tell the velocity of the flow around the wind turbine blade. In addition, we take pressure measurements on the surface of the blade from which we can determine the forces that are acting on the blade. Using these two pieces of information, we can better determine how these forces are varying with time as they would when they are on a wind turbine blade in the field. A wind turbine is a device that extracts energy from the wind, takes the energy inherent to the wind when it's blowing, turns it into rotational energy, and then that rotational energy drives a generator, and the generator produces electricity. When the wind turbine extracts energy from the wind, it leaves a region of lower energy wind behind the wind turbine. We call this the wake. And that wake propagates downstream, and if it encounters another wind turbine, then that wind turbine isn't seeing the undisturbed wind, it's seeing the wake of the previous turbine that has less energy. Our laboratory has some unique simulation capabilities. We're able to calculate the flow around an entire wind turbine and actually look at the effects of one turbine on another turbine that's located downstream. It's very important to be able to predict where these wakes go so that when you're designing a wind farm, you can place the turbines in the best locations so they spend the least amount of times in the wakes from the upstream turbines. The key issues for wind energy today are reliability and cost of energy. The research we're doing here, we hope, will lead to higher efficiency and longer lives of wind turbines that will enable more energy from wind to get onto the grid.